SkyTel radar, much of the action is to the south and, of course, offshore. That's where the bulk of the action is going to be. When you look at infrared satellite, a couple things you start to notice. Brighter colors here means possibly stronger storms developing, but still not necessarily by definition a tropical system. Just an open wave at this point, still dealing with shear, even though not so much land interaction at this point. So here's what we got. We got top winds at 40, which would typically classify it as a tropical storm, but still has to closed itself around a center of circulation. That is yet to happen. Forecast to happen as it moves into a better environment. And that could happen as early as this afternoon. We'll be looking at a tropical storm well offshore with watches posted for the northern Gulf. That's where we'll likely see a landfall, possibly Monday night, Tuesday morning. For us, futurecast, mostly cloudy and mostly dry. Here's 10 a.m. We'll start to see a couple of those outer bands move in. Then when Fred makes its closest pass, we'll start to see the rain coverage increasing. I think that'll happen as we push towards later this evening, 5, 6, 7, 8 o'clock. Much of the action is going to be along the coast. A couple could spread inland as waves of showers move through. Maybe a few more in the morning. Scattered showers expected tomorrow afternoon. In terms of rainfall totals, likely not enough to cause some flooding, although if we see training storms, that could be a different story. Most of us get under an inch. And the severe risk today is very low, but I-75 west with some of those bands. As we typically see on the east side of a storm, we could see a couple of rotating storms. A water spout or tornado, not impossible, but it's not likely. All right, the other one watching is Grace. This one's a minimal tropical storm at this point. A lot of land interaction here, passing just south of Puerto Rico, then Hispaniola, Dominican Republic. That includes Haiti, Cuba. A lot of land interaction here, and then some questions as to where it ends up. Right now, the cone is south of our area, but of course, something we'll be watching is computer models still having a tough time with it.